wanted to talk. His unpopular opinion was, is this how he spells his name? Did you type this in right? I don't even know how to pronounce it even. Go for it. Tell me.
What, his unpopular opinion?
Yeah.
Mark Stoops is overrated.
That's an unpopular opinion.
I'd say that's pretty unpopular, yeah. Considering
that he's overrated.
Taking us to a bowl win and getting recruiting classes, yeah. So,
okay,
yeah.
Now let me push back just quickly on that, though. Should he have gotten us further faster with the recruiting classes he's brought in? And I'm asking you, Clark, because you're like football, but...
We were in the gutters in terms of talent when he took the job. Joker Phillips just completely forgot how to recruit talent.
Okay.
And so you could argue that we were the worst Power 5 job in the country at that time.
Okay.
So knowing that and knowing that we had to start a few true freshmen in the SEC, you knew it was going to be a while before we could actually, you know, win any games that actually meant something besides, you know, the UT Martins of the world, the Charlottes of the world. And last year we finally started to do it, obviously beating Louisville, beating South Carolina, beating Missouri, those tweener teams, you know, that usually... The tweener teams, that, you know, the games that could go either way. They could be wins or losses. They're between the...
Isn't that every game, technically?
No. All
right.
No. You know UK football. No, that's not every game.
Well, wait a minute. The SMU game couldn't have... Not SMU. The Southern Miss game... I guess it is SMU. The Southern Miss game couldn't have gone either way. It did. We thought we had them.
Yeah.
Well,
I mean, if you remember my takes, I thought
I'm going to remember your takes from last year.
Of course, you should.
Go ahead. Because
they had, I forgot the quarterback. I think Mullins was his last name.
Yeah, I'm not going to remember anymore.
But he was coming out of 2015, year before last. He was one of the most efficient quarterbacks in the entire country. And if you know, our secondary is pretty dog poop. So knowing that,
they could have put up.
Yeah, dog poop.
All right, fine. Let's not repeat it. Anyway. All right, so anyone else want to push back on that? Is Mark Stoops overrated? Oh, Chandler's going to – hang on, Chandler. I'm going to put your mic on. Go ahead.
I'm glad you turned me on.
Yeah, I am. Well, you have to talk loud in that mic now.
So when we say he's overrated
– Yeah, we don't say it. Daryl says it.
Okay, so Daryl, what's the bar? Like, where is he overrated at? Because
– Well, let's go back into – wow, just all kinds of craziness going on at the end of the segment. Let's go to – let me ask you this. What I said was is that should he have done more, so more wins, more bowls – In the 4 years now that he's been here, or is he on track? Now, I would argue that whether it's incremental or whether it's great, as long as we're moving forward.
Here's the thing. He was never sold as a Jim Harbaugh, right? He was never sold as he was going to come in here, Urban Meyer at 12 months, and all of
Very
a sudden
fair.
We're going to be
yes.
a 10-win team.
Nor did we expect that, by the way. I mean, realistically.
When somebody's saying he's overrated, like, that's exactly what they're expecting.
Well, yes, Daryl. But I wonder if Daryl really believes this. And he dropped off, and I don't think he did intentionally. Daryl lives down in southeastern Kentucky. Sometimes you lose that cell phone reception. But I wonder if Daryl's just like, this is an unpopular opinion. Because Daryl has his own show that he digitally broadcasts on Facebook and Twitter, I think. And so I just wonder if he's like, okay, well, this is one that I've heard. I don't know. Maybe Daryl believes it. I don't know. So
right now, I think Stoops has built something, you know, and you got to give him time. It's just like building a business, right?
Yeah.
By day, you got to build it up. And as long as we're improving year over year, then he's not overrated in my mind.
Well, my frustration is that you've got 4 years, as far as I'm concerned. If you're a coach, unless you do something egregious, I got to give you 4 to 5 years if I'm an AD.
Depends on the school.
Why? Why does it depend on the school?
No. It depends on the school.
Why?
Like, expectation, right? Because if you're the University of Florida.
But expectation does not necessarily kowtow into realism.
Yeah, that doesn't matter. That's what it,
but
that's
it
the
should.
Way it is. That's the way the game's played now.
Well, but we're talking building a program, right? If we're talking building a program. By the way, I brought you on to talk barbecue, not this. If we're talking about building a program, then don't you have to give a coach at least 4 years, no matter who he is, no matter what program, to build his program?
You absolutely should.
Okay, that's what I'm saying.
But that doesn't mean it's going to happen.
And that
also doesn't mean that that's what the fan base expects, right?
That's true. That's very true. And by the way, sorry about the mics in here, folks. I know we keep going high and low. We've got 3 mics in here that we've got to adjust, and they're just impossible to adjust. So we're doing the best we can. Clark certainly is. Anyway, let me give out the numbers again. 859-280-2287. 1-800-606-4263. Tonight. Coming up at 8:30, we're going to talk to Chandler Lyle about Lyle's Barbecue, which is the hottest dinner outlet in Lexington right now, formerly of down in Nicholsville, and he's moved it up here to Clay's Mill in Lexington. Chandler and I are going to actually debate lemonade coming out later.
You're going to lose.
I'm going to lose. I'm not getting into it now. I've got my arguments made. They're succinct. They're not at all succinct. Okay, we'll talk about them for hours. We're going to talk more about tonight's topic, which is, what is your most unpopular opinion? You against the world. When it comes to UK athletics, we'll take more. This is Cameron Mills Radio, brought to you by LHC Group.